I am going to share today a Gino gem on ultimate market indicator to warn you about a bear market and a bull market. One of many internals I use. This one I actually developed by back testing years ago, and it has been a rock star for signals. I paired up with my other ones like the AR high low and a couple other advanced decliners, but it's one of many. It's simple. It's simple. All you do is take any chart and you go to the chart SPX, you want the S&P, you change it to a weekly. It has to be a weekly because it's a longer term trend. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to introduce the MACD, MACD, MACDaddy, Moving Average Convergent Divergence. So when I go to my studies here and I load my MACD, let me find my MACD here. There's one little trick. There's my MACD. It's a special one. It's 8.17.9. Now, every software defaults to like a 14 or a 25.50 or an 8.16. You want to go in there and edit yours to 8.17.9, exponential. And what that does, and remember, this is on a weekly S&P. What that does is it gives you moving average, convergent, divergent, and measures momentum. It's a momentum indicator. And what I like about this is I back tested it, and it's a trend indicator, especially on a weekly. Again, a longer term type trend. So this is one of those things when it gives you a warning, you have to take it seriously. And it's simple as this. Let me back this up. I'm going to back this up quite a ways. I'm going to go like 20 years because it's warned me of every bear market. And let me show you how that works. I'm going to zoom in right here. When the MACD, when both of these lines cross over and start heading down, that is a bearish trend. But you want to worry when the first line breaks the zero line. That means bears have taken over. And when that second line breaks, that means you better be only bearish because the momentum is going to speed up to the downside. And look what happens here. And you only go bullish when they're both back above. So right here, you start feathering in, but when you go bullish, right there. So you see what it's measuring is momentum and all the math of the moving averages over time, the longer term trends. So if you got out here, you got it back in here, you missed ruining your portfolio, your IRA, your 401k. You missed that downtrend. You got out. Or if you're a trader, you took advantage of that downtrend. Now go back to all the major. This is the 2000 November when it topped all the way through 2008, 2009. That was one of the biggest. So when you get that warning, be very careful. Here's another one. Back in 2015, the end of 2015, going to 2016, you can see we're double topping here. But what's going on as the market's double topping? Momentum is going down. You get those two lines, guess what? It says stay out. You get a little pop here, and it says get back out. You don't get back in until right here. So when you get that first line crossing over, you favor the bulls. So where are we at today? Where are we at today? And that's why I'm bringing this one up. Uh-oh, we have the first line just about to cross. Am I going to take this seriously? Yes, we have FOMC this week. Depending on where this week closes, you know, these crossed over about over a month ago. But the momentum is pointing down. If that line crosses, I'm favoring the bears. Look for bear sectors only. And if both those lines cross over, most of the time it's recession. That's my signal for recession. Now, by the way, we always pair this up with the ADD, which I'll talk about, and our AR high low, which I developed years ago. It has been bulletproof. It's been hard to find a better bear signal. There it is, another Gino gem on finding market internal signals. That is the MACD, MACD, 8.17.9 S&P weekly only. You can put on other indexes, but it works on the S&P great. There you go.